Hello, everybody. Welcome back.
It's Drawing with Woodsy time. My name is Michael Woodside, and I'm an animator. And today, I'm going to teach you how to draw a character. So while we discuss who that is, I'm going to do the old washing of the hands. Obviously, it's important to stay clean still. I don't know if you guys are aware, but we're not out of it yet. So I'm just going to clean my hands off, because I want to make sure that we start clean and then end clean. So we're just doing that. Okay, so I put up the call today to see what we were going to draw, and there was an interesting response from people. It was a lot of cutesy characters, and then one specific character kept showing up over and over and over again, and you guys are in a mood, so we're going to draw Hades. Hades from Hercules. I say, what do you guys want to draw? And then everyone says the devil. So let's do it. You know what we normally do. I'm going to start with a blue pencil. I'm going to do my underdrawing in a blue pencil. And I also have a light blue pencil that I'm going to use for his fire hair later. And then I have this black outline pencil that I'm just going to darken colors with. So if you haven't done this before, then prepare to make some mistakes with me, because I'm going to make some mistakes and you're going to be following along. So let's just figure this out together. Let's straighten it up. So the first things we always do, what do? We always do these circles on the top corner of the sheet. I'm going to move this over here. There we go. That's better. And this is just to warm up our arms and hands. It's important when you're doing a drawing to not feel like you have to make it perfect, because you're learning how to do this. We're learning together on the sheet of paper how to draw. So the blank sheet is always super scary to use. So by doing these little circles, you're also kind of ruining the sheet of paper, and it doesn't need to be a perfect drawing, because we're gonna learn how to do it. And then after you learn how to do it, you can draw perfectly. So I just do a bunch of these. You can see that I'm moving my whole arm and not just my wrist. And this helps move more cleanly through the lines. If I were to use just my wrist, it could be a tighter line, but if you get in close, you can see that it's kind of shaky and it's not really, doesn't have a flow to it. So doing this helps you loosen up, and it's important to be loose, especially because we haven't done this in a long time. It's October now. I think we did the first ones back in March, so a little rusty. Let's give ourselves some more time to warm up. If you've missed the other classes, they're all still on YouTube. We've done 45 of them, I think, together here. 40, almost 50, so there's a bunch you can go back through. Cool. All right. So Hades has a weird shaped head. I don't know if you remember the movie, but he has a really long top of his head, and then he has fire coming off the top, and then a really long chin. So we want to leave some room on the page for that. So I'm going to draw a circle right here in the middle of the page. Leave some room on the top and the bottom. And you can see when I draw these circles, I'm not trying to do it in one line. I'm always going over and over and over again. And you're allowed to be sloppy. That's why we use different colored pencils. So if you only have one pencil, you can just draw this really lightly. If you have multiple pencils, then you can do whatever you want. Because later we'll go in and darken an area. And then in doing that, it helps us tell the audience where to focus their eyes, and then what lines to ignore. So you can see once I do that, then these other blue lines just sort of, they exist, but they're not the focus. And then once we shade things in, then it's even more so. Okay, so you remember this guy. This is the little ping pong ball to show which direction we're going to be looking at the character. Today we're going to draw Hades straight on. So if he were to the side, it might look like this, like that. And these lines help us to figure out which way the character is looking before we draw all the details. It's always tempting to get to like the eyelashes and everything first, but it doesn't make any sense until we get the structure down. So we're just going to draw right down the very middle, vertically, a line. And remember, I'm moving my whole arm, not just trying to do it this way. It's one quick move, and it's a bunch of little lines, but somewhere in there is the middle, I promise. And then, let's say this is the middle. We're going to go right below the middle. I'm going to draw the horizontal line. So you see this kind of, if you've done the Mickey class, it's starting to look like Mickey, but very soon it will not look like Mickey. Kind of a similar setup. Okay, so let's just go ahead and finish the head shape. So the top of the head is like an upside down letter U. If you think of it like a pill, so this is the circle. We're just going to draw a practice over here. It's kind of like that. So I'm just going to go up, and it's almost as tall as the circle. He's got a really big forehead. So I'm just going to loosely rough that in. Have you guys had a good summer? It's already the fall, right? Today in Burbank, the weather is perfect. The high today is like 75 and it's cloudy right now. It's amazing. Didn't leave a lot of room on the top of the thing for the fire, but we'll get it. Okay, so as long as the top of his head was, his chin is even longer. And that is like a sharper U down to the bottom. So it comes more to a point. So you see, this is like a really good practice area. You can just do whatever you want over here and no one will ever know. Alright, so now let's do it for real. So actually, I'm going to extend this down just so I know where the middle is. Really lightly. We're going to give him a little chin detail later, so I don't need to go be too precious with that part. Okay. Then we have Hades' head. Listen to this music and appreciate getting this far. Okay, so he's got these pretty cool cheekbones that are like, if you remember when we've drawn the top of Mickey's head, we have the little, what we call the flapping birds, right? It kind of has some sideways flapping birds, like a V, that come out here and then end up at this line. They're not as rounded, they're kind of straight. It's almost a V, but... they just connect into the forehead, the temple area, and then down into the jaw. Okay. That's the head shape. We did it. Now we're going to start building the nose. So the nose is like a really tall V. It's almost like a, if you imagine a big tall glass, like a champagne glass celebrating a holiday. It's like that kind of really tall shape. So I'm just gonna start above, probably about halfway between the middle line and the top. Just start drawing that V, and it goes down below the bottom of the circle. Let's just finish off the nose by giving him his nostrils that come up to the side. So the nostrils are kind of weird shapes. We're gonna slowly build them together. So starting from the bottom of the nose here, I'm just gonna draw kind of a slanted line that goes out to the side like that. Connects to the bottom of the circle. And then we're gonna do another rounded line that goes up, kind of like a parenthesis. And then just a little bit coming back. That's that nostril on that side. And then the other one is the same shape, just kind of on the other side. And it's gonna be a little bit higher. He's gonna have kind of a sneer face. So we're gonna go a little bit taller with that bottom line. Just barely. If I were back home in Florida, I could show you guys all the drawings I did of Hades when I was a kid and the film came out. I used to draw him all the time. That will not be proven in this, it's been a while, so no problem with this. Okay, so that's our nose. Well, that's his nose. We're going to, let's start building his expression. Come on, Lola. All right, so just to do that really lightly, I'm gonna draw a diagonal line coming from the top of the nose up above the cheekbone, all the way out to the side. He's a villain, this is what you guys wanted, so he's gonna be a little sinister. And then the other one, I'm gonna go a little bit higher. So this one, if we ended it on the same side over here, it'd be there, but this one's actually gonna go even higher. Straight line. So let's give him a little forehead meat, a little brow meat. So he doesn't have like hairy eyebrows, they're just lines. So that's gonna be the eyebrow. Side. And just to make it a little bit different from, so it's not the same on both sides, this one has a rounded line here. I'm just going to make this one a straight line. And that kind of gives it a little bit of interest, visual interest there. Okay, so to finish off the eyebrows, he has these little bumps, like little, I don't know what to call them. Meat bumps, it's a weird thing to say. They just sort of stick out a little bit outside the head. This cheek a little bit bigger. Making the cheek on this side a little bit bigger, connect there. Whoa. Music wanted to play. All right, so his little ears, I do a straight line out that way, and then a curved line back here. It's music of bothers. Let you take a look at that shape. Wow, that was a 180 that music just took. So the animator for Hades was Nick Ranieri, of course. He's somebody we've drawn his characters a lot. Lemire, most recently. While we stop there, I'll show you some Nick Ranieri drawings. I have in this book. So he was the supervising animator there. And for Hades, and you can sort of see a preview of what's coming. for the drawing of him. At least what parts are still left to go. But really solid but loose drawings. Here's another linear drawing. From this book, Disney Sketchbook. That drawing. You see how goopy his lips are? We're gonna have fun with those lips in a second. That's a weird thing to say. We're gonna have fun drawing those lips in a second. Great. The style of this movie is a lot different than other Disney movies. And they were building off of the style of an artist, Gerald Scarfe. And his artwork is here on the right side. This is from, I'll show you the book. From this book, Design. But you can see he has these really great flowing lines. And one of the Disney artists, Sue Nichols, she did the drawing of Hercules and Meg in the green frame. She helped translate all of his designs into really animatable shapes, dimensional shapes. She's a great visual development artist. She actually just passed away this year. She worked a little bit on Moana as well. So Ron and John went to her often because she's great. Anyway, beautiful artwork. So what should we do next? Let's go ahead and start with some eye shapes just to start blocking those in. So starting from right about where the circle intersects with this line, we're just gonna outline that coming around. And once it gets to the side of the head, we're gonna bring it right back. It's just another little rounded line that gets to the center line here, the horizontal one, and then bring it right back up to the nose. So, this is an interesting design element that he has in common with characters you might not expect him to, like Simba and Nick Wilde. Scar, definitely. But those characters have what's called the eye mask, and we've drawn it several times before. But you have the eyebrow, and then a big shape underneath that, and then within that is the eyeball. This just helps separate it, and for him, it really feels like bags under his eyes. We're going to shade that in later. So, now moving in towards the center on this eye, we're just going to draw what would be a circle. If we were to draw the whole circle, it would go over to the nose, like that. But we're only going to see the part underneath that diagonal line, because the eyebrow is in front of the eye, so it would block it. And since this one is kind of squished, we're going to squish the eye, so it's not going to be a total circle, it's going to be more like an oval. Drama! Let's give him kind of a lids halfway down expression. So he's evil and also not interested. It's kind of a horrid expression. And I'm just gonna give him a little outline here for more bags under his eyes. And then from here we can just do the pupil. There's no color to his eyes, so it's just a black dot. I'm gonna give him a little bit of a highlight, not a huge one. He's not a happy guy. So I'll just put a little circle in there, and then I'll color in everything except for that circle. We're gonna go back over this with the black That'll just help me remember to color that in. Seeing his chin for me is a little bit wide, so I'm gonna start narrowing it so you can get down to the bottom. This side was fun. And at the bottom, I'm gonna draw a circle that's kind of off to the right side a little bit. So it doesn't poke out on the left side, but it pokes out over here. Remember I said we're gonna go back into the chin and make it a little different? It's this part. So he has this little curly Q that happens here. We were looking at the Gerald Scarfe drawings before, and he does that a lot. Really strong chins. So if you see Hades from the side, his chin might poke out like this. Okay, so let's start building the mouth. So he's gonna have a sneer, and let's just start with a cheek. So starting from this point where we made this curve of the nostril, just gonna do another curve that goes out this way. And what that means is that this side of the mouth on the right side is gonna be higher than the left side because that nostril is pulled up. If you guys do that with your own face, just pull your nostril up to the side, you can feel your mouth is going up with it. So it's all connected. So that's what that little line tells us. Tells us a lot. Okay, so his mouth, it's gonna be a weird shape. We're gonna build it slowly. Let's do it. So starting on the left side, over here, just below the nose, but closer to the nose than the chin, we're gonna draw a diagonal line going up this way, just really, really lightly. And that's just gonna give us a rough path for our mouth to go. Otherwise it could kind of fall to the side, but we wanna make sure that we keep this diagonal, so I like roughing it in like that. And so his lip is like, his top lip is like a, it's like one of these birds that we've drawn, but slanted, right? So we're going this way. So I'm going to practice on this side. Starting here, I'm just going to go up, and then like that, and then the second part of the bird goes all the way out to the side. So it's much longer on the right side. So if we were to do that here, remember this is the middle line, so we want that to be the middle. The second part goes all the way up and over there. So that is kind of the center line of the mouth where the lips meet together. So on top of this will be the upper lip, and below that will be the bottom lip. And the upper lip, it's going to be thinner than the bottom lip, so I'll let you catch up to that part. Cool. So upper lip still has big, thick lips. So my hope is to get the lip right up next to the nose. So if the nose hangs over it a little bit. And then this part of the lip is bigger, kind of loops around and connects to that point. And you can start to see the disgust in his face. Okay, so the bottom lip is bigger, so we're just going to start over here and draw a rounded line like that. Same slant, so it's kind of a little S curve. We talked about that in other classes. This is an S. If you think about the letter S, just stretched up and down, it's something like that. So we're always drawing C curves or reverse C curves, S curves, reverse S. Straight lines. Those are really good lines to practice. So this is a kind of sideways S-curve. And then our kind of stretched out, reverse C. From this point, they're just really long kind of curved lines that go out to the side here, just curve away from the head. It's got a really, really wide neck, which is a lot of fun to draw. Animators love things like that because that gives more things to play around with, so you can have a lot of tension in his neck whenever he's angry, or get a lot of great shapes if he wants to lean forward. You can sort of do that ignoring this eye, but do that sort of thing, pull the neck forward. Okay, so now he's Hades. If he's super mad, then you might draw the hair in red. I'm doing it in this light blue, which is the color that they use whenever he's kind of just neutral, not very angry. So the way to do that, I'm just going to draw a rounded V that connects right here in the center of the head. And I have my lighter pencil here. And it goes above. And it just wraps up off the page for me. I'm not a good planner. And to get the rest of the head shape, I just like drawing really lightly the lines up here. And this just sort of gives you the rough depth that there might be the flames coming off of his head. But all of this stuff back here is behind the forehead. And then here you can just do a little light curly Q lines for the where the flames come off. So this is where those S-curves really come in handy. You can do your own thing. Try to make it different on either side so it's not similar, because fire is always moving and kind of random. To shade it in, what I like doing actually, because it's a specific thing, let's try this out. I'm gonna start shading from the bottom, and then as I get to the top of the flame, it's gonna fade out. So I'll just show you in a practice flame over here. So starting from the bottom, I'm gonna shade darker, and then just let it fade out to the top. So the closer it gets to the head, the darker it'll be. And then as we get away from the head, it gets lighter. And this just shows that the fire is definitely more intense the closer it gets to his skin, and then once it leaves, it kind of dissipates. People have asked about this desk that I use when I animate or when I draw. This is just a traditional Disney animation desk. We're offering them at work a few years back, and I grabbed one as fast as I could. So it would be a table like this that Nick Rainier and the other animators would have animated Hercules on. Maybe they did. And so it has this disc in the middle that rotates, and then also there's a light underneath if you wanted to see through the drawings. So not as useful for these videos, but it's a really great tool. If you don't have that, but you have a glass dining room table, that's another good thing you can use, but it gets hot fast, so be careful. I used to put my drawings up against the window, tape them. Anything with light behind it will help. And as for what tools I use, this is a pencil I probably bought 10, 15 years ago that I just found is the right color blue. So I don't really have like a, I'm not a type of pencil guy. I will just take whatever pencil I can find. Okay, so that's the fire and the hair. I think it might be time to start outlining our drawing. So this is where I'm gonna take my black pencil and just to go all the way around, make sure that we cover all of our bases. Every time I sharpen, it breaks, so yeah, great. Okay, so I'm right-handed, and I'm gonna start outlining the drawing from the top left over to the right so that I don't smudge it. If I start over here and then move my hand here, then it's just gonna push everything around. So we're not gonna outline the flames because that's done in blue. So I'm just gonna start outlining the head. Again, this part's flame, so I'm just gonna let that stay. I like this design too. It feels like the male pattern baldness, where if you think about character, just might have hair that like disappears off to the side here. It's gonna happen to me. It's gonna happen to all of us. So they kind of replicated that with the fire design. It's really creative. So this part, the eye mask, remember we said we're going to color it in? So I just want to make sure that I separate all these parts so you can see which parts are darker than others. Thick eyelash, so I'm going to go a little bit darker on that side. And then eyeball. You see as we're doing these black lines, the blue ones sort of disappear. Okay, so I'm just going to shade this part in, kind of a neutral gray. So I'm not pushing too hard with a pencil. And then his top eyelid, I'm just going to shade it in a little bit lighter. This line is all the way over here, so I'm just going to get it done to the neck. Just outlining the right side, not the left side. Okay, let's go back to the face. need that in. Shading in a little bit of the ears. You see that a lot of the hard work is done in the blue line, and then the rest of this is just kind of, it's not tracing. You want to make sure that it still feels new. It still should feel like it's dimensional and has a purpose there that is outside of the lines you already drew. I used to listen to the soundtrack all the time when I was a kid. Two copies of it. I got a copy of the soundtrack for my birthday one year, and then a friend of mine for the same birthday got me a copy of the soundtrack. So he was actually playing as the party started, and I hadn't gotten his gift yet, and he was in a weird mood, and I was like, "What's the matter?" He's like, "Just open your present." And I was like, "No, it's great. I can have one in my bedroom, and then I'll have one in the living room, and they'll both be playing." And I was inventing surround sound before it was out there. All right, we're gonna shade his lips too. So his top lip is gonna be, just go a little bit darker than his bottom lip. But probably only as dark as we did the upper eyelid. And the bottom lip is just, and doing them in two different colors helps separate them so they don't feel like they're one shape. If you want to, we can just take this blue that we colored in earlier. His skin is kind of a gray blue, but if we just do it really lightly, that'll help separate him from the rest of the page. And also, we'll minimize how much we see our little construction lines, because you don't have to do this part if you want to leave it sketchy. Typically, the animators aren't coloring in their drawings like this. This looks like the face Hades would make if he knew that we were drawing him to this music. So, forgot to mention this, I do this often, I've mentioned it before, but if you're new, you see that this whole shading in process I've tried to do using the same angle of the pencil, at least in certain areas, and that just helps keep it consistent so there's not
accidental cross-hatching and things getting darker than they should. And just smooths it out so that people aren't really focused on the shading of it. And in fact, I'm even going to go over this gray with the blue just to help bring it all together. Forget the neck. I also have my pencil tilted sideways too, so I can cover more page, and it'll also be a little softer and a little darker here. His head would be casting shadow on his neck there, so just a little bit, just to give us some dimensionality. If you don't know what dimensionality means, it's this idea of just giving it roundness and form, so it's not flat. So you can see even on here, the orange is really bright here, and then it fades out as it goes to the sides. That's because the light is over here. So in doing that little fading here, we're kind of letting the audience know where the light is. Makes it feel more real. So as you're shading too, try to follow the forms. Do with my colored pencil a few lines in here just to give them some forehead wrinkles. Nothing too fancy. Last thing we're going to do is color in over our gray here. Remember, top lip is a little bit darker, so I'm just going to color it in and darker. And then the bottom lip is lighter. But it just ties it in with all of the rest of the shading that we've done. Last shading in the eyes, just to give it some depth, I'm just going to shade the top part. Of the whites of his eyes, just to make the lid kind of poke over, even shading a little bit into our little highlight there. He's got really heavy eyebrows. And I think that's it. I think we drew Hades. So the last thing we gotta do, sign our name down at the bottom. And there we go. So I have my sanitizer. I'm gonna clean up again. I suggest you do the same. Thank you for joining me on this beautiful Friday. I'm going to go outside in a second because it's so nice out there. I hope you guys are staying safe inside. And when you go outside, you have masks on. And it feels like we're going to get this thing behind us someday. We're heading in that direction. So anyway, thank you for joining me, drawing Hades. I hope you have fun. And remember, just because we're separated doesn't mean that we need to be alone. So thank you again for joining me on this Friday. Bye now.